Hello students, we are going to discuss about honesty, courage, cooperation and commitment. One by one we will discuss. First we are going to discuss about honesty. Honesty means expressing our true feelings. To be able to be emotionally honest, we must first be emotionally aware. This emotional awareness is related to our emotional intelligence. It is our emotional intelligence which gives us the ability to accurately identify our feelings. Emotional intelligence may also give us the ability to decide when it is in our best interest to be emotionally honest by sharing our real feelings. We would be better off individually and as a society, we would be more honest. If we are more honest with ourselves, we will go to know our true selves on a deeper level. This would help us become more self-accepting. It could also help us make better choices about how to spend out time and who to spend it with. If we are honest with others, it may encourage them to be more emotionally honest. When we are emotionally honest, we are more likely not to be asked or pressured to do things which we do not want to do. We will also find out sooner who respect our feelings. Next one, questions are arising. How society discourages honesty? It takes awareness, self-confidence, even courage to be emotionally honest. This is because in many ways society teaches us to ignore, repress, deny and lie about our feelings. For example, when asked how we feel, most of us will reply, fine or good. Even if that is not true, often people will also say that they are not angry or not defensive when it is obvious that they are. Honesty generally, it is one of the prized values of mankind. Honesty is an insurance against failure and defeat. An honest man is a big asset to the family, to the organization and to the society in general. Honest person may not earn riches, but he will certainly earn name and satisfaction of living a good life. Benjamin Franklin says that honesty is the best policy. Are you clear? Some of the actions of an engineering professional that leads to dishonesty: lying, fraud, withholding the information, not seeking the truth, not maintaining confidentiality, giving professional judgment under the influence of extraneous factors, that is external factors. Being honest may not get you a lot of friends, but it will always get you the right one. Second one, courage. What is courage? Courage is a tendency to accept and face risk and difficult tasks in rational ways. In our day-to-day lives, virtue of courage doesn't receive much attention. Courage is a quality reserved for soldiers, firefighters, and activists. But for today's world, security is what matters most. Perhaps we were taught to avoid being too bold or too brave. It's too dangerous. Don't take unnecessary risks. Don't draw attention to yourself in public. Follow family tradition. Don't talk to strangers. Keep on eye out for suspicious people. Stay safe. Winston Churchill says that courage is the first of human quality because it is the quality which guarantees all others. Courage is classified into three types. One is physical courage. People with high adrenaline may be prepared to face challenges for the mere thrill. Second one, social courage. Involve the decision and action to change the order requires leadership ability. Intellectual courage. People through acquired knowledge, experience, sports, education, and training. Look before you leap. One should perform SWOT analysis. SWOT analysis is nothing but strength, weakness, opportunity, and threat. Calculate the risk. Compare with one strength and anticipate the end result. While taking decision and before getting into action. Courageous people own and have shown the following characteristics in their profession. Sustained hard work, perseverance, experimentation, preparedness to face the challenges. What about the result? Unexpected result. Involvement, attitude, clear and firm resolve to act. Commitment, willing to get into action and to reach the desired goal by any alternative but ethical means. Courage is resistant to fear, mastery of fear, not absence of fear. Third one, cooperation. Man is a social animal. He lives in a society on which he is largely dependent and to which his contribution matters. Man cannot make his living all by himself. He has to depend on others for many things. Usually many workers have to be done by several persons collectively, that is team spirit. Construction of a building, running an institution, organizing a community function or meeting require the work and the help of many individuals. These can be successful only if everyone cooperate with one another. Team spirit present with every individual engaged in various professions. Example, we are taking engineering. Working together ensure coherence, blending of different skills required towards common goal. I have discussed with one example. Industry is a place where the successful manufacturing of a product is the outcome of the collective effort, that is team spirit, cooperation and dedication of a team of engineers with the expertise along with skilled workers. Engineer basically has to learn the art to liaise, coordinate, cooperate with the various other units to complete a task. Again, the concept of what goes around comes around is followed. By cooperation, the world can be made a better place to live. The obstacle to successful cooperation: clash of ego of individual, lack of leadership and motivation, conflict of interest based on region, religion, language, caste, etc., ignorance and lack of interest. Last one, commitment. I have discussed with one example. Every individual, when grown up, has to perform one or other duty, not only for his livelihood, but even for the betterment of social and national condition. We may say commitment starts right from student days. Student has to commit to study, not only as a matter of routine, but with devotion. If we want to secure high grade or high marks and win rank and medals, so is the case with a teacher. If he is not committed to his profession, he cannot be a good teacher. Are you agree? He has to devote his time for referring books and preparing notes. He has to be punctual, loving his profession, develop a liking for students, be fair and impartial, that is very very important in classroom, and imbibe discipline in and outside the classroom. He should set for himself and impress upon the student high moral standards. Another example for commitment: farmer has to be highly committed to farming. His profession of agriculture depends on so many external factors. What are the external factors? Soil type, climate, good seed, manure, rainfall, proper irrigation, etc. He is not timely in carrying out his operation and carry them out efficiently. To grow a bumper crop, he cannot harvest yield. He has to be watchful of market prices and sell his produce at the right time. They agree. Till then, he has to store his produce in good condition. All these require commitment on his part. A slight delay, what will happen, can wash out his entire season effort. This is the one example for commitment. Another example, engineer being on intellect and a professional must discharge his duty with diligence, devotion, commitment at all times. History is full of examples, war heroes, scientists, men of industrial business achievement, which are landmark. If parts of the world are civilized, prosperous, wealthy, strong, due to what? Devotion of their immunerable individual who worked with commitment to their duties. Are you clear or not? They have made this a world, a pleasant place to lie in and enjoy the fruit of their hard, diligent work done day and night. Students, keep in your mind, hard work never fails. Win say that the quality of a person's life is in direct proportion to their commitment to excellence, regardless of their chosen field of endeavor. Are you clear or not? Okay. Thank you for your attention.